Now, if you're a photographer and can't work because of this pandemic, what on earth do you do? Well, you get your bike out, you start singing in the saddle as you cycle south. That's what, and that's exactly what my first guest is doing.
Kat Orman. The Sound. The Sound of Oxfordshire. And all the music you love. BBC. Radio Oxford.
Let's go, girls. Come on. I'm going out tonight. I'm feeling all right. Gonna let it all hang out. Wanna make some noise. Really raise my voice. Yeah, I wanna scream and shout.
Twain, I feel like a woman. It's BBC Radio Oxford. It is Friday. It's the countdown to the weekend. And you know what we do on a Friday? We do Foodie Friday. And my guest chef will help you connect with nature. So that's on the way a little bit later on. Also, we'll tell you how you can get behind some local lines as well. Now, it's been a cycling sort of week on the show, actually, and today is no exception. How would you like to spend a penny or a pound and help the creation of some local art? Cathy Hatton from Oxford is a photographer and her work has been stalled by lockdown. She turned this negative into a positive and has used the time to fulfil her real passion, making music. She's produced two albums and wants to make more, and so is taking on a massive cycling challenge to raise funds to support her work. And Kathy joins me right now. Kathy, good morning to you.
Hi, Kat. Thank you for such a lovely introduction. That's really beautiful.
Well, it's well deserved as well. Where are you at the moment? What can you see? Because you actually started out on this challenge yesterday.
Yeah, yesterday at 4 o'clock in the morning, heading out. But it was really nice. When by the time I got to Bloxham, there was a friend of mine called Brian and he bought me flapjacks.
Oh, that's lovely. Yeah. Everyone needs a friend like Brian.
Yeah, he's called Brian the Lion. He's brilliant. So, hello, Brian. from here I can see it's a beautiful sunny day and I'm really looking forward to getting on the bike to Sidmouth today.
Wow, okay. So how many miles then did you do yesterday?
Well, I was supposed to do 108, but I did 93 in the end because basically I had some problems with my sat nav and I ended up in fields and so I realized that actually knowing your route is really, really a valuable thing. But then I got to Bath and I realized, you know, I do live in a hilly place, but there are serious hills there, and I was it was coming on night time as well, so I just thought I better stop here.
Yeah, I think 93 miles is actually very, very good going. I mean, is this something that are you pushing yourselves to the limits here, Kathy, or are you a cyclist anyway?
No, it's just that I really care about the environment, and I during lockdown we had all that beautiful clear air and It gave us this little insight into how things could be. And even though it's, you know, so tragic about the reasons we had lockdown, but some beautiful things came from it because we did have a chance to see what other possibilities there are. Mm. And so I just started cycling then, and I started doing 6 miles, and then I was recording at Woodworm Studios. And that was 20 mile round trip. So I thought I'm gonna, you know, cycle there. And then I just thought I'll cycle to the shops. I'll cycle everywhere. And I wanted to sell my car. And I said to my kids, and they weren't too keen. So I don't use it. I try and use it as little as possible now. And I just like to cycle everywhere because my daughter's in uni in Falmouth. I thought, well, I wonder if I can cycle down there and back. And then I thought, so I've been training for that. I've just been cycling as much as possible and sort of learning about how much I need to eat and how when I need to take breaks and things.
Yeah.
I've forgotten what I was going to say.
Yeah, but it's interesting actually that, you know, through this whole kind of challenge, you're learning about yourself, you're learning about your determination, and your own body and maybe, you know, the limits of your own body.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, realizing that you have to constantly eat. Mm. And if you don't, it's just like it's like having petrol in the car. If you don't eat the car, you can't carry on. So, you just have to just keep eating. And I'll tell you what, after this, I think that I may just be glad of a rest of eating. I have to eat so much.
But you wouldn't be doing this, really, if the lockdown hadn't struck and the pandemic, of course, hadn't struck.
No.
So going back to, you know, day to day doing your photography business and, you know, just I guess you just you're on this treadmill, aren't you? And you just keep on going because, you know, you have to pay the bills. You've got to work. You've got to work to live, etc. And then you don't think that anything else is a possibility. And you certainly don't think about maybe the things that you really want in life. But I think actually that's what you did think about when pandemic struck, the things that you really wanted in life.
Yeah, it was like actually having time to do. And I think this is where so many people, so many friends have said this, that we actually had a chance to have time and spend time with our families. And I mean, obviously there's, you know, very different circumstances where people haven't been able to see each other. And that's, you know, that's what my song Into Each Other's Arms is about, the missing the people that you love. But I think that, I forgot.
I think it was really that, you know, what I was trying to say was that you had an epiphany because you did have that time. And and that time for thought and that time for thinking about really what mattered to you. And actually, that is something, like you've said before, that so many of us were able to do. And we were able to spend time, more time with our families. And like you say, more time just appreciating the outdoors and the environment as well. So am I right in thinking then, because you talk so passionately, I mean, music is in your heart. Was photography really the plan B?
Yeah, I think, you know, many of us, we kind of do the things because we think we need to be able to make a living from it. And we think, well, we can't do that because, or, you know, such and such a reason. But yeah, it was like, well, actually, I've got time to do it now. I can and give it a go. Mm. And also, I think something shifted because maybe we just started to do things differently and think differently. And it makes you realise that actually we're all very, you know, the whole system is very fragile. Mm. And it kind of, when you realise that, you actually realise that you can change things. Mm. And that's what this journey is about for me. It's about, because there's so many, there's so much negative, well, there's so much upset at the moment and people feeling like they don't know what's going on, and we get contradicting information all the time. As it being on the bike, it makes me feel empowered. It makes me think I can get from A to B, and I don't need to pay any money. I mean, obviously, that's my son's bike, my son's bike and my son's helmet. But yeah, you know, to just actually, and you feel free out in the fresh air. Mm. It's such a wonderful feeling. So it is. Yeah, it's really about empowerment and hope, and that each of us, when we can bring ourselves together, because at the moment there's been so much division. Mm. And actually, it'd be lovely to just be more together.
So, Cathy, the pandemic pressed very much your reset button, and you realised actually that life is precious and you shouldn't put off doing the things that you actually love to do. But also it gave you, because it pressed your reset button, by the sounds of things, it gave you almost the material and the song material, the lyrics to actually write about, because of your change of, you know, your shift of priority within your life.
It's more that it gave me the courage. It gave me the courage to, because I think that I've hidden away because I've been too scared to do things, and to, especially to do the music, because you really are putting your heart out there. But it was a bit like, well, actually, there's so much I've got to say, and I want to be able to say these things, and I mustn't let fear get in my way. And I think love overrides fear, and so that's what
I think we've all learned that. Love overriding fear, certainly in the past few months for us all. Look, we're going to hear some of your music in a few moments' time. And you stay there, because we'll return to our conversation in a moment. My guest is Cathy Hatton. She's doing 600 plus miles cycling down south. All in a good cause. We'll talk more about her music and why she's doing this. And of course, her son's bike. Does he mind? It's BBC Radio Oxford with a 1975. They're the 1975. If you're too shy, let me know. It's BBC Radio Oxford now. Back to my first guest this morning. Her name is Kathy Hattam. And by day, she was, before lockdown, and she still is, of course, a photographer. But lockdown happened. You re-evaluated your life, Kathy. You thought, I want to do what makes me really happy and I want to make more music. You started doing that. And you're now cycling to raise more funds so you can continue making music. Is that what you want to do? You want to call yourself a singer-songwriter?
I don't really need to call myself anything. It's more, I just got stuff that I need to say. Mm. And it's really, especially the more things, you know, I feel people are misrepresented by the media in many ways. And I just think that we're so much about love and beauty. And so that's what I'd like to be saying, because I think that the more of us that keep saying that, the more that we stick together. Mm. That's really so.
Well, we've proven that, haven't we? Because actually, you know, love overrides fear, as you said that before. And there's been such an outpouring of love and support and help for people during the pandemic. You know, strangers helping strangers.
Yeah. So really lovely. Yeah.
It is a proven thing, and it does work. And wouldn't the world be a better place? In fact, the world did become a better place. In some ways, yeah. Not all, of course,
yeah.
But in some ways, in terms of that help over the course of the pandemic. So we're going to hear the music in a couple of moments, but I just do want to ask about the bike, because you did say that it's your son's bike, it's your son's helmet. Did he offer, or did you just, you know, did he take it?
He was like, Mum, will you get off my bike? Get off my bike. And I said, oh, Sebastian, please. Oh, so I got to say a really big thank you to my daughter and my son for just being so, so amazing. But yeah, he's eventually got used to the idea. And I've said, well, look, you're going to have a sat nav. You know, by the time when I finish, you'll have a sat nav and you'll have other attachments to the bike. So I think he's coming round to the idea now.
Yeah. Let's hear some of the music, actually, because I'm going to play. You mentioned Into Each Other's Arms. Just give us a little bit of a background when you wrote this and the kind of message that you wanted to convey.
Yeah, I wrote this during lockdown, and it's just about missing the people that you love.
Okay, well, here's Into Each Other's Arms. That's my guest, Kathy Hattam, and Into Each Other's Arms. I just think that we can all relate to that, because I don't think there's many people that haven't missed somebody over the course of the last few months, Kathy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Who were you missing the most?
Oh, well, I missed actually just being able to cuddle friends, and I still do, being able to cuddle your friends. You know, usually when you meet them, you give them a hug, and like now it's like trying to do virtual hugs and things. And it's kind of that, I think it just deep down, it probably is just making us all quite sad, because we can't do the connect in the same way as we would have in the past, and maybe the way that we always took for granted. Mm. And so, yeah, I think that there was, yeah, I think it's really that. And also, for me, it was a deeper meaning of having lost my dad at a young age. So it's kind of, you know, about losing someone.
And had you written about that kind of grief before?
No, not really. No, I think that something definitely shifted during lockdown, just a perspective, and it just really. I suppose I really accessed a deep part of me, which I thought, I just thought that there's no, it's a waste of time to try and be anybody else or try and fit in. we've got one life and it's very short, and we all have a purpose, and we should just we have things to say. And that's what I feel, is we've all got a voice, and although we might not feel we have at the moment, because we can feel very small in comparison to the country's problem, that we can make a difference in our, you know, and bring people together. That's my main thing, is that we stick together.
Yeah, and that's absolutely the message that I'm getting from your music. I mean, how would you like people to support you? Because, you know, you're back to the bike ride. I'd imagine literally you're chomping at the bit right now, because you want to get back in the saddle on your son's bike. Thank you, Sebastian. And you want to get down to Falmouth, of course, and complete this challenge. So in doing so, of course, you are fundraising, aren't you?
Yeah, I've got a GoFundMe page, and people are, you know, I'd written on there that if, because I know, you know, everybody's really stressed about money and struggling, and have very heavy hearts about that. But I thought, well, maybe if people would be able to donate £1, they might be able to afford that if they wanted to support me and support my music. But people have been amazing. Like, I've just been bowled over by it, the support and the love. Actually, the love that I've, you know, my friends, it's just, it feels like it's all bringing us all together. And yeah. So that's a, so I've got a GoFundMe page anyway. And
so what's the GoFundMe page? How can people find it, Kathy?
If you Google Kathy600, and or you can go on my Instagram page. There's a link on there to all my different online pages, and my music on Spotify. Mm. And I really hope you enjoy the music.
Well, thank you, Kathy, so much for coming on. And I hope actually the support, you know, also in turn has given you the confidence to know that you can do your music, you can make a living out of your music, and you can make people happy with your music as well. Are you going to continue to do it alongside your photography when you can get back to doing the job, perhaps, that pays the bills?
I think that I just think that I would really love to find a way to be able to pay for our food and stuff like that from the music, and so that I could spend my time, because that's where my heart is. But I do love the photography too.
Well, we wish you the best of luck with that. And can we catch up with you once you're in Falmouth and you've been reunited with your daughter at uni?
Yes, I love that. And Kat, just to say thank you so much. It's been such a brilliant interview. You really get what I'm about.
Pleasure's all mine, Kathy. Take care and good luck. Your love is key.